Get ready to match the stars. Comedian Brad Garrett. From the home show, Dana Fleming. Match game zone, Charles Nelson Reilly. America's TV sweetheart, Sally Struthers. From not necessarily the news, Tom Park. And from the home show, Paula McClure. As we play the all-new star-studded match game. And here's the star of match game, Ross Schaefer.
Welcome to match game. Thank you, Gene. Wow. Hi, stars. It's crazy. For those of you wondering what's going on, this is National Samoa Week here at the Match Game. Sorry. No, it's the land of my people. Welcome, everybody.
Maybe turn up the air conditioning for those folks.
Yes, we had to turn up the air. Now, look at this, Dana. Dana and Paula, both from the home show.
That's right. Oh,
yes. And you, what did you say? You have crafts and tips for us?
We got them galore. We are replete with crafts.
I love this one. The last time they were on the show, they taught us how to make tire chains out of macaroni.
That was a good tip. It works.
That was a good tip. And Tom Parks, of course, is back with us.
I need these. Yeah.
And Sally Struthers.
Yay, Sally.
In fact, this was not made on the home show.
But we could make that.
You could make that on the home show.
With macaroni.
With macaroni.
Oatmeal.
All right,
oatmeal.
Let's get started here. Hiya, Gina. Good to see you again.
Nice to see you guys.
You have a lot of fans out there.
Yeah, friends and family.
You collected $4,200
yes,
the last
I did.
Time you showed up. Eric, you'd like some of that, wouldn't you?
Yes, I would.
Now,
yes,
why don't you tell us about yourself?
Well, my name is Eric Simmons, and I'm a software engineer in the Los Angeles area.
You're a software engineer?
Yes.
Oh. Good for you. Ready to play match game?
You know it.
Okay, the object here is to get correct matches, and every time you do, you get $50. Winner goes on to keep his or her money and play super match for shot at $10,000. Gina, you're the veteran. A or B?
A, please.
Okay.
Apple.
Starting to sing, Paul?
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah. All right, this is kind of a holiday, post-holiday question. Santa said, during the holidays, Mrs. Claus got a bit absent-minded. For Christmas dinner, she cooked my favorite blank. Oh. That's the Gene Wood dancers. All right, Gina. Santa said, during the holidays, Mrs. Claus got a bit absent-minded. For Christmas dinner, she cooked my favorite...
Elf?
My favorite elf. Oh. That's a good answer.
Hello, Ross.
That's a very good answer. Hiya, Brad.
You've seen my show. It's called The Broken Home Show. Have you heard about it? We have meals for one recipes, and every day we just, you know, she gets a chair, he gets a TV on the show.
Oh, that's fine. Watch it.
Elf? Did you say elf?
Yeah, she cooked my favorite elf.
They taste like chicken.
Do they?
Elf.
Elf!
Elf!
Everybody says about rattlesnakes. Oh, have a rattlesnake. It tastes like chicken.
Tastes like chicken.
Yeah. Dana?
Well, with a little reindeer dressing.
Oh.
Elf.
All right.
Elf. Look at this. Two for two, Charles. Make it three.
No, I'm not going to make it three. I'm sorry. I was quite that cannibalistic.
Well, what happened? What happened?
I said I didn't spell it right because I didn't have a governess. I was venison.
Venison?
Well,
those look like people that you had a seance. They would.
Well, isn't
would
that deer?
Burn venison?
Is that deer?
Venison.
You've never been on a hunting trip?
No, but we had no hot water or nothing. We came home from school. We had fish sticks. We didn't have venison.
He was thinking about venison. Really.
Could we use fish sticks as an answer? Would fish sticks work? Harold, I think what's happening is venison. It's venison.
Stop.
I want to know how to get around the antlers.
Oh, please help me, Ross. Help me.
Look, we have stereo Charles and his mind is
Okay.
Sally. Mrs. Claus got absent-minded, and for Christmas dinner, she cooked my favorite...
Well, she stuffed it with an elf, but she cooked a reindeer.
A reindeer.
Oh,
reindeer. Oh, don't turn on her. Hiya, Tom.
See, I think reindeer is way too big to be cooked by mistake, and it had to be...
All right.
All right. Oh, dear.
I'm really worried. I really am. Because I was thinking about Rudolph, and I said reindeer, too.
You said reindeer.
Thank you.
Reindeer.
I spelled it wrong. Oh, I was thinking about Rudolph.
You got three matches.
Oh, it's okay to kill an elf, but not a reindeer.
Not a reindeer.
Come on, will you explain that to me?
I mean, an elf is okay. I'm really hurt. I'm thinking about Rudolph now.
You're taking it too seriously.
Okay. Right. Let's go on. Pete said...
Pete
said, boy, was my blind date a dog.
Well, I'll tell you. Well, I'm ugly.
I put my arm around her and got blank.
I do artwork as well.
Yeah. All right, Eric. Pete said, boy, my blind date was a dog. I put my arm around her and got...
Fleas.
And fleas. Yeah.
Yeah. Was she a dog, Brett? She was a dog. I mean, ugly, you know? I'll tell you. She had marks all over her body when she was touched by a 10-foot pole.
That's funny. Charles, did you like that one?
Please. Yes, Dana.
I'm real worried because this is twice in a row Brad and I have been on the same wavelength.
Oh, you have some fleas at the match. It's a match.
It's not fleas. It's a cheap sweater. Fleas.
Oh, fleas. My blind date was a dog. You have three wonderful dogs. No,
I have four dogs.
Four dogs.
Three Chinese chows, Chester,
chow.
Chester, Chuck, and Ed.
Chester, Chuck, and Ed, the chow chows.
And a Newfoundland named Haley. She weighs 150 pounds. You wonder how ugly this date was?
Yeah.
How ugly was she? She was so ugly that they had to tie a pork chop around her neck to get the family dog to play with her.
Oh, what an answer.
Yeah. I heard Rodney Dangerfield say that once, didn't I?
Oh, you sure did, baby.
Yes, he's right. Okay.
Put my arm around her and got...
Well, I hope this counts. It's half right. Eric, flea-bitten.
Flea-bitten?
Flea.
Yay. Flea again. That's a match. That'll take that.
All right.
Senor Parks.
The collar probably should have been the tip-off.
Oh, please.
I was thinking that, and I said I got bitten.
And you got bitten,
bitten
with one
teeth. Bitten, and I did get bitten. Oh, it's happened to me.
You're in the lead, Derek. 250 to 150. We'll take a break. Come back with matchups, folks. Oh, Dana, the first round here. Gina has 150. Eric jumped the lead with 250. Time for us to play matchup now. And Gina's where you can build up your score by playing against the clock. All right? You're behind, so we'll start with you. Who do you want to play with?
I like to play with Brad, please.
Okay,
Brad,
okay, but first let's stick to the game.
Okay.
Shall we?
All right. Sure, you have possible matchups. You pick what you think is the best answer, and every time the two of you agree, you get $50. Okay, let's put 30 seconds on our clock. Ready? Go. Upper blank. Upper class, upper hand.
Upper class.
No match. Play blank. Playboy, play house.
Playboy.
No match. Carry blank. Carry nation, Carrie Fisher.
Carrie Fisher.
Match. Save blank. Save face, save the whales.
Save the whales.
Match. Milton blank. Milton Bradley, Milton Berle.
Milton Berle.
Match. Best blank. Best man, best friend.
Best man.
No match. Ted blank. Ted Danson, Ted Koppel.
Ted Danson.
Match. Fly blank. Ah, out of time. Nice job. Good job. Four matches. Okay, Eric, your turn. Who do you want to play with?
Okay, Tom.
Tom, you're up.
All right, Eric.
All right, $50 for every match. We'll put 30 seconds on our clock. Ready? Go. Leg blank.
I didn't hear you.
Leg warmers, leg of lamb.
Leg warmers.
Match. Crocodile blank. Crocodile Dundee, crocodile tears.
Crocodile Dundee.
Match. Love blank. Love boat, love connection.
Love boat.
No match. Dennis blank. Dennis the Menace, Dennis Hopper.
Dennis the Menace.
No match. Food blank. Food fight, food for thought.
Food fight.
And then that's a match. West blank. West Virginia, West Side Story.
West Side Story.
Match. Out of time.
Okay. You also got four. There's our score. Eric Stoner leads 450. Gina, you have 350. We will come back and play more of Match Game, folks. Stay with us. Okay, we are back. Gina, we'll start with you.
Okay.
Eighth. Okay, we'll start with A.
In the delivery room, the doctor said to Ethel, "You gotta level with me, Ethel. When the circus came to town, did you sleep with the India Rubber Man?"
Oh, my goodness.
What? Are you with me so far?
Gotcha. Yeah,
Ethel said, why? What makes you ask? And the doctor said, "Because you just gave birth to a 7-pound blank." It's a pretty sight.
Indian Rubber Man?
India Rubber Man, yeah.
India?
India.
India Rubber Man.
East India Rubber Man. There's the answers, Gina. When the circus was in town, did you sleep with the India Rubber Man? Not you, of course, but Ethel. Sleep with India Rubber Man? Because you just gave birth to a 7-pound...
ball.
A 7-pound ball?
Yes.
7-pound ball.
Ball.
Okay. 7-pound ball, Brad.
Well, I said rubber band.
A rubber band. 7-pound rubber band? What'd you say?
Hang on, Shirley. A rubber band from the India Man.
Rubber band, rubber band. Charles?
Well, now that we heard from most of the elf murderers... All by the right answer!
Bouncing ball.
That is so good. I'm so jealous. That is so good.
Very good, this game, isn't it? Sally?
Well, it's probably because Brad and I look so much alike, but yes. I said rubber band.
And you said because you gave birth to a 7-pound rubber band, too. Tom gave birth to a 7-pound what?
Speaking as one of the elf murderers, beach ball.
Beach ball. Are they taking that?
That's a ball.
Oh, yes, they are. Good. Say yes. Good. Two match. Paula, what did
you thought say? Ball, I thought rubber, and then I thought rubber band.
Rubber band?
Band.
Rubber band. Well, she got a couple of matches there. Tied the score up. Eric, who we just learned, speaks French.
Oui.
Yeah, Tom, you speak French.
Well, I studied for 7 years while I was driving around the country touring, and for 7 years it was, pouvez-vous me dire où est la salle de bain? La salle de bain est ici, la salle de bain est ici, la salle de bain est ici, la salle de bain est là-bas. I can ask directions to anything in France.
Hola, qui pasa? It's about as far as I
can. Well, this is not about a French farmer. This is a regular farmer named Greg. And he is the world's dumbest farmer. I am delighted you're curious. He doesn't nail shoes on his horse. He nails shoes on his blank.
These questions get tougher and tougher.
It's not an easy game, Eric. They have their answers. Farmer Greg's the world's dumbest farmer. He doesn't nail shoes on his horse. He nails shoes on his...
Chicken
shoes. Chicken shoes.
And I said nail on his wife.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. No match. Dana.
On your children.
Oh, on
they
your children.
They never lose it.
Nail on the children.
The elf murderers are meeting in Santa Monica on next Monday at True.
I'll be there.
His wife.
Oh. His wife. Didn't nail shoes on his horse. He nailed them on what, Sally?
He nailed them on his own feet.
On his own feet.
Well,
good answer, but not a match. Tom?
Kids.
Oh.
Kids.
Well, I was thinking a little bit like Eric. Instead of chicks, I said cows, though.
On the cows.
See?
The cows.
Yeah, she's
all right. Tied up now. Here's time to play a final matchup. Whoever's ahead at the end of this round will win the game and a chance to play for a possible $10,000. So, Gina? You're in the champion seat. You'll get to go first. Who do you want to play with?
Sally, please.
You and Sally.
Yes.
All right.
Sally.
Go with Sally.
Good.
Right. Go ahead, honey.
All right, you know that matchups are worth $100 right, now. Yeah. And you get 45
you can do it,
seconds.
Sally.
Get as many as you can. Good luck to both of you. Ready? Go. Blank it out. Shout it out. Work it out.
Work it out.
No match. Blank light. Spotlight. Limelight.
Spotlight.
Match. Blank priest. Parish priest. Judas priest.
Judas priest.
Match. Blank setter. Irish setter. Trendsetter.
Irish setter.
Match. Blank series. Mini series, world series.
Mini series.
No match. Blank dreamer. Beautiful dreamer, American dreamer.
Beautiful dreamer.
No match. Blank fever. Yellow fever, Saturday night fever.
Saturday night fever.
No match. Blank throat. Cut throat, sore throat.
Sore throat.
Match. Blank business. Show business, funny business.
Show business.
Match. Blank Sullivan. Ed Sullivan, Gilbert and Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan.
Match. Blank ring. Engagement ring. Bathtub ring.
Engagement ring.
No match. Ooh. Thank you. Yeah, six.
Okay, Elliot. Now it is your turn.
I would like to play with Charles.
Oh, you want to play with Charles? Nelson Reilly? All right, she has 1,050.
Good luck, everybody.
You have 450. You got to beat 1,050 to win this game.
Okay.
All right, let's put 45 seconds on our clock. Good luck to both of you. Ready? Go. Blank ribbon. Hair ribbon, typewriter ribbon.
Hair ribbon.
Match. Blank nuts. Grape nuts, beer nuts.
Beer nuts.
No match. Blank vision. Tunnel vision, x-ray vision.
X-ray vision.
No match. Blank defense. Legal defense, self-defense.
Self-defense.
No match. Blank heights. Pacific heights, fear of heights.
Fear of heights.
Match. Blank white. Egg white, Betty white.
Betty white.
No match. Blank phone. Hold the phone, princess phone.
Hold the phone.
Match. Blank secret. Deep dark secret. I've got a secret.
I've got a secret.
Match. Blank crystals. Ice crystals, Folgers crystals.
Folgers crystals.
Match. Blank nickel, out of time. You won it, Gina.
What is this?
Congratulations, Gina. Good work. That was a tough one, Eric.
All right.
Well, thank you very much for playing.
Thank you, too.
We have some nice
things
for backstage. All right, we'll be back with our Big Money Super Match. Stay with us, folks. Here we go. Time for the Big Money Super Match. It's really funny. When you won that, you go, oh, my heart is beating. My heart is beating so... Your heart is up here, Gina.
Well, it was affecting the whole part of my body, but... Everything was pounding.
Everything was pounding.
I could feel it here.
Tom.
Yeah. I was pounding.
You were pounding.
I was.
So was Brad. We were all pounding. Yeah. All right. So we're going to start with an audience match, Gina.
Okay.
We polled a recent studio audience, got their best response to this. Heavy blank. Now, if you guess the most popular answer, you get $500. Second most popular answer, $300. Third best answer, $200. And you can get some help from three of our celebrities.
Charles, please.
My second album. Heavy metal.
Okay, heavy metal.
Heavy metal. All right, two more.
Brad, please.
How about heavy duty?
Heavy duty's great. One more.
And Sal.
Heavyweight.
Heavyweight. Good. Heavyweight. Heavy duty. Heavy metal or heavy of your own?
I think I'll go with heavy metal.
Heavy metal.
Yeah, that's a good one.
All right, we'll see if you're right. What is the $200 answer, please? Heavyweight.
Ah.
That was Sally, wasn't it? $300 answer is heavy duty.
Could be.
There's a good shot. The one that you want is behind the $500 answer. Is it heavy metal?
Thank you.
Okay. So far, so good. You've never flexed for us like that, Charles.
Charles and I never met an Italian girl with hair like that named Gina whose heart was low. I'm going to lift it.
Oh, we're going to see if you can play for at least 10 times your amount or $5,000. Okay. Double that amount if you get a great spin on our star wheel. Why don't you come up here? Okay, Gina.
There it is, ladies and gentlemen, the Goodson Petri dish.
All right, Gina, just give the bad boy a spin.
He's funny, go. Big bucks, Gina.
Thank you.
Tommy boy.
Oh. Look at that, Gina. All right.
He's okay.
Tom, we're playing for $10,000 here.
He did.
To win that money, Gina has to have an exact match. Please, no help from our audience. Turn to face me, if you will. Tom, write down your answer for this. Indianapolis, blank. Indianapolis, blank. Oh, he took no time
Get
at all.
Get those lead nails ready.
Gina, what were you thinking about? Indianapolis?
500.
Indianapolis 500. There were several answers. Tom, can you match Indianapolis 500 for $10,000?
It's a great football team. It's a great football team.
No one likes them.
500.
Genius total, stay with us. $15,250 for Gina. She comes back as our champion. We hope you will join us next time on Match Game. Until then, I'm Ross Taylor, folks. Bye-bye.
Departing contestants will receive Little Debbie snack cakes by the box or single pack. Delicious, individually wrapped, and so economical. Little Debbie, America's number one snack cake. Cutco's kitchenette cutlery set comes with the five most commonly used kitchen tools in a convenient storage tray. Quality cutlery made in America by Cutco. Your choice of his or her watch from Lucien Picard's Royal Collection, crafted for dress and sportswear. Stylish two-tone bracelet and Swiss movement from Lucien Picard. Speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson television production.